have you ever?
This is where the uh-huh comes in.
Have you ever?
But you should have known it. I wasn't going.
Yo, yo, yo. What's going on, Legacy Kings and Queens? Welcome to the second episode of Royalty Talk. I'm your girl, Mel.
B.
And the B stand for what?
Beans.
Uh-huh. That's how y'all do it, right? Today, we're going to dive into a somewhat controversial topic. It is what a lot of individuals, relationships, and friends will consider a difficult conversation to have. It requires personal accountability, being realistic with yourself, and being willing to make the necessary changes to move forward in life. So let's get into it. All right, guys, today's topic is access to your healing. Who are you giving access to the healed version of you? What brought about this topic is a meme that we saw on social media, Instagram particularly, and it stated, and I quote, "You've healed too much to not raise the bar on who has access to you." I'll read it one more time.
Just
it needed to resonate. Let it, what country say? Country Wayne, let it sizzle in your spirit. All right. You've healed too much to not raise the bar on who has access to you.
Preacher. No.
Listen.
Okay.
Because whoever wrote that was in the spirit.
That was
all right.
Serious.
I present the question now to Big B. As I present it to her, I'm also asking you guys to answer the question for yourself. Do you still allow people that have broken you in your past to have access to the healed version?
Absolutely not. From experience, I do not allow certain people that have chose to mishandle me. Let me just say that.
That's a strong word.
I do not allow people that have mishandled me in the past to have access to who I've grown to be today.
By saying do you, it is asking you if you currently do it. But for those of y'all who say, I don't do that no more, I cut that off. I present to you, have you ever? This is where the uh-huh comes in.
Uh-huh.
That is. Have you ever?
I have allowed people that have broken me have a certain limit of access. For example, the kid's father. We have to have access with each other due to the kids. You didn't see that coming? Because I'm going to keep it all the way funky. Like,
you going to keep it what?
Funky. Like,
how old are you?
Relax. All right.
She said funky.
You're doing a lot. All right. So, for example, my ex, Nicholas, when we separated, there was a point in time that we tried to remain friends, and that was so hard to do because the mindset that I was in at the time, I no longer wanted him to have access to me, because the time that you had full access to me, you mishandled me.
So, question. That period of time when you guys were trying to be friends, had you already healed?
No.
Okay, so now we're touching on something even bigger. Yeah. Broken people who have not healed from the brokenness, allowing the people who broke them to still have access to them.
That's even worse. Mm. But that still falls in line of people not even acknowledging that they're broken. Mm-hmm. So once I was at my limit of disrespect, the damage, the lies, the cheating, once I was at my limit in that relationship and I chose to walk away, he wasn't ready to let that relationship go and wanted to remain friends. Once he decided to move on, he still wanted access to that friendship version of me. And because I've already healed from our past and our relationship, you no longer get this healed version of me because I'm not who you used to know. I'm not tolerating the disrespect. I'm not tolerating the lies. And we tend to allow people in our lives based off of longevity, like based off of history, and just because, oh, we were cool, you know, you're a really good friend, but you're not a good partner. Nor do I want to disrespect what I currently have.
Right.
You no longer have access to that no more. You made your choices, stand on it.
I think that a lot of times when people from our past who have hurt us, in this segment we're referring to it as broken, because if you weren't broken, you wouldn't need to be healed. Let's just call it what it is, okay? They broke you. It's all right. They didn't break the whole part of you, but they broke a portion of you. It's okay.
No, for sure. Thank you for
it. Yeah. It's clarifying. Because when you say broken, people are like, I ain't broken me.
Yeah. No. No, it's hurt. You know.
They broke a part of you. They didn't necessarily break who you are at the core and all that, but they broke a portion of you, whether it be your heart,
your feelings,
how you view yourself. They broke a portion of you, and it's okay to admit that. And I think that's a big problem that we have, is trying to keep face for other people and trying to keep face, honestly, for ourselves, because a lot of times we feel stupid that we allow somebody to play in our face like that.
And take them back
and over
and over.
That we're not honest with ourselves. I was broken, and now I need a period of time to heal from it so that I can move forward. So what we have is a bunch of broken people keep attaching themselves to other broken people, and then keep wondering why the hell their house so damn broken.
For sure.
You're not going to get a complete house when you're missing pieces.
You got to be careful, man. Like, I get that you have a connection with people, and there were good times. There were fun times. But once you take the moment to weigh out the good and the bad outweighs the good.
Come on, Tyler.
You have to put yourself first. And it can get lonely. It can get bored. But it's necessary. It's almost court ordered to heal who you are, heal where you are, mentally, physically, emotionally.
And this is not just a subject for females. Males deal with the same problems too. And I'm going to be real with you. If you go on social media and you see the type of bras that's out here for these men to pick from, you can say, oh, well, females are the way they are because men did this. Some of these females are just like that. Not her.
Because why are you pointing at me?
Relax. I pointed in that direction. I really pointed past you.
No, I'll wait till we run the camera back.
It was past you. It wasn't like this.
You was pointing at me.
It's back. Not her. But men deal with the same type of issues. And fellas, I'm going to tell you right now, because all men who didn't come from bad homes, and everybody wasn't missing a father growing up, and after a certain age, that's no longer an excuse for you, my brother. It's so many different examples that you could pick to utilize on how you want to mimic, you know, how you want your life to progress and what type of man you want to be. But what I will say is this. Men don't have a lot of space to allow themselves to heal. The pressure that the world puts on them, the pressure that these new broads, I'm going to keep calling them broads, because until you start acting like a full-blown woman and conducting yourself as such with woman expectations, I'm going to keep calling you a broad, okay? the way these bras put pressure on men, don't even have time to process. Yeah. And I'm referring to the good ones. I don't need nobody commenting talking about, they all dogs. My baby, I don't need to hear none of that. Because this is what happens. People post something geared towards men, and females get in the comments, well, now, not everybody like that. Okay. But you want to know what? Not every woman is like that either. So I'm talking to the men who actually are about something.
Acknowledge it.
Okay? For sure. We have to create a safe space, especially within our community, to allow broken men to safely acknowledge that they are broken so that those who would like to can heal, so that when you do meet said man, you have a healed version of the man.
Sure.
Most of the time when you get hurt, ladies, it is because you have taken yourself, whether broken or healed, and joined together with a broken man who is still in denial about being broken because society tells him he's not allowed to be broken.
He's not allowed to cry. And the sad part about it starts when they're young.
Very much so. That's what a root of it is.
You fall off a bike and get your ass up. You a boy. You a man. You can't cry.
Now let me say this.
Nigga, what? Do you not see this cherry? This shit hurt.
Let me say this. My one rule, and it's whether male or female, cry when there's a reason to cry.
For sure.
Don't just be out here throwing tears and I ain't had no snack. He ain't took me out to dinner. Don't do all that, because I don't have no sympathy for that, bro. Cry when you're supposed to cry, when there's legitimate. You ain't starving, so you ain't in pain. You just being greedy. Okay? When it's a real reason to cry, we have to allow men space. And not this ain't just for black men. It's black, white, whatever, man. Yeah. Spanish, I don't care, bro.
Yeah, don't put no race on it.
That's why I just been saying men.
Yeah.
We have to allow men a safe space to acknowledge that they're broken. Give them the tools and the room to heal.
For sure.
And then you could come over here. But when a broken man get with a broken woman, and everybody get the pointing fingers at each other on their brokenness, what have we healed? What have we accomplished? Not a damn thing.
Had more broken pieces.
And then wonder why your children come out crazy. Uh-oh. They came from two crazies. Huh? I've been holding that in, apparently.
I don't.
Woo! I feel better than you. All we're trying to tell y'all is there are literally three steps to you being healed and maintaining your healing. One is acknowledgement. A hurt person is a broken person, whether people want to acknowledge that or not.
Hurt people.
Which is literally the world that we live in. Being broken is not necessarily a bad thing. We live in a world where recycling is so prominent as taking something old, allowing it to be molded into something new. But we need to allow ourselves that space to say, I was done wrong. And that shit hurt. It hurt, and it broke my heart. I gave this person my heart, I gave them my feelings, and they broke that part of me. That portion that I gave them, they broke it. And we need to acknowledge that and be realistic with ourselves instead of trying to play tough, because you playing tough is not getting you anywhere. So we have acknowledgement. Then we need to allow ourselves to go through the healing process. You need time for that. But once you do finally heal, absolutely, you have to limit the access that people have to the healed version of you. If you don't, you will continue to be stuck in this cycle of being broken and healing, broken, healing, broken, healing. And it'll never end until you become callous to loving yourself, to loving others. But I can't even stress acknowledgement enough, because that's what I feel like people are struggling with the most. They're in denial.
I have been on this wave of self-love, even in a relationship. I still am accelerating within myself, because I have not allowed anyone to mishandle me, because now I have boundaries, which a lot of people don't have. I have set standards, and I have short-term and long-term goals. And it took me to move away and just remove people out of my space to find myself. And then I didn't do clubs, I didn't do bar hopping, I didn't do reckless sex, I just stayed to myself. And I encourage you, whoever is listening, whoever this resonates to, if you're dealing with that, don't be afraid to walk away from what is hurting you. Don't be afraid to be alone and find the strength to love on you. If you have little ones, love on your little ones, and give energy to those that show you nothing but pure love. But if there's someone around you that's causing you pain, don't allow them to have access to you.
No matter who they are.
No matter the longevity, no matter the history. You know, like I said, you have good times with people. But sometimes it weighs you down, and you just need to choose you. That's my message to you guys. Choose yourself. It's going to be okay. You can live without someone, especially if that person is causing you pain. And you never know. Once you've healed and you moved on and you just living your life and you like, I'm not dating nobody, I'm focusing on me.
That's when the right one
every time. Just trip on to be in life, and you get your seat moved, and then they put you in a scenario a day to where you gotta. No,
what's happening?
Oh, all right. So
the beautiful thing about memories, because a lot of times that's what holds us people that have broken us. Oh, they wasn't bad all the time. They have moments, but. Beautiful thing about memories is you can always make more. So you can always have those memories, but you don't have to live in your memory. You're allowed to move forward.
For sure.
It's okay. They might not be okay with you moving forward, but that's a personal problem. You're allowed to move forward.
Give yourself that grace to accept what it is.
Acknowledge, heal,
and limit access. That's our message to you guys today. Love y'all. Thank y'all for tuning in. Make sure that you answer the questions that were asked in this video in the comments below. And we'll see y'all next week, I guess.
Word.